County Deputy Sheriff that got killed this past week. Thank you very much. All right, appreciate everybody coming out tonight. Let's start out with a roll call of officers.
Supervisor Ron Alberico.
I'm here.
Trustee Bart Boyce.
Here.
Trustee Dean Morelli.
Here.
Trustee Bart Delaney.
Here.
Trustee Greg Biggis.
Here.
Highway Commissioner John Chulinski.
Here.
Assessor Debbie Mason.
Here.
Collector Karen Johnson, he's absent. Attorney Gary Mueller.
Present.
All right, thank you. Next is, this is the Roden Bridge meeting right now, just to let everybody know. We have the approval of the minutes of the monthly meeting of February 5th, which includes the February 26th recess meeting.
I'll make that motion.
Motion by Barb Delaney.
I'll second it.
Second by Barb Boyce. Any questions of the minutes? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? All right, we have bills of $42,711.07 for the Highway Department.
I have a motion to pay the bills.
I have a motion by Barb Delaney, or Barb Boyce, to pay the bills.
Second.
Second by Barb Delaney. Any questions of the bills for the Highway Department? Hearing none, can I have a roll call, please?
Alberico.
Yes.
Boyce.
Yes.
Morelli.
Yes.
Biggis.
Yes.
Delaney.
Yes.
All right, motion carries. Any citizens wishing to address the board here tonight for the road and bridge? Seeing none, we'll go to Janice. Highway Commissioner is on the board.
Thank you very much, Ron. Obviously, nobody's here to see me, so I'm here very quickly. You know what? I just want to just put out the word patience. We're going to have a couple of nice warm days. I've had people call and find out if they're picking up branches already. We still have the plow stuff, the plow equipment on the trucks. We do have all the branch pickup dates in the newsletter that will be out soon. And we do have our snowplow equipment still, you know, wanting to not get off of the truck. So we're not out of the woods yet, but be patient. I think the weather's going to be awesome this week. So if there's anything that you need from the Highway Department, please give a call. And the other thing I wanted to mention was I'm starting to notice, it's hard for us to notice streetlights that aren't out because we don't usually go out at night unless we're plowing and usually we're looking down at the road, not up. So I beg you guys, I would ask and plead if you see streetlights that are out in the township, please give the Highway Department a call. They're maintained by ComEd. We pay $6,000 a month for street lighting, so we want to work it. So I had one lady call and tell me, oh, my streetlights out, I hate to bother you. That's what they're there for, bother us. We don't mind one bit. So I'm going to keep that short, and that's pretty much all I've got at the moment. I'm a rusty cook. Did you guys all hear me there?
You wanted to repeat or no? Okay, so
then,
hey,
just talk to me. Which is okay.
All right, I have no other business tonight for the Roden Bridge Fund, so I would, unless a trustee has a question or comment, I would entertain a motion to adjourn.
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
I got a motion by Greg Biggis.
Second.
Second by Barb Boyce. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Thank you. Moving on to our General Assistance Fund. Again, you have your minutes. You have the monthly meeting of February 5th and the recess meeting, I believe. Is that the 26th? It's not down here, but I think it's the 26th.
Yes.
Of February. I do need a motion to pass the minutes.
I'll make that motion.
I got a motion by Barb Boyce.
Second.
Second by Greg Biggis. Any questions of the minutes? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Thank you. You have bills of $325.24 this month. Do you need a motion to pay the bills?
I'll make that
Yes.
Delaney?
Yes.
Pickens?
Yes.
Marley?
Yes.
Boyce?
Yes.
All right, any citizens here wishing to address the board for the general assistance fund tonight? Seeing none, we'll move on to new business. I really have no new business in general assistance. The only thing I have in old business is you do have your monthly aid, financial aid monthly report. We had one requalified for GA, and we had two that were denied this month. And you have your financial aid breakdown as to what we handed out. Other than that, I have no other business in general assistance unless you have a comment or question. Trustees. Hearing none, I would entertain a motion to adjourn.
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
I have a motion by Greg Pickens.
Second.
Second by Bart Delaney. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. All right, thank you. Moving on to our senior fund. Again, you have the minutes of the monthly February 5th meeting and the recess meeting of the 26th. I do need a motion to accept the minutes.
I'll make a motion to accept the minutes.
I got a motion by Greg Pickens.
I'll second it.
Second by Bart Delaney. I'm sorry, Bart Boyce. I know who you are. I'm just getting Bart's on that stuff. Any questions in the minutes? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. You have the bills of $4,000 and $4,034.73. We do need a motion to pay the bills.
I'll make the motion.
A motion by Bart Delaney.
Second.
Second by Greg Pickens. Any questions on the bills? Hearing none, can I have a roll call, please?
Alberico?
Yes.
Boyce?
Yes.
Marley?
Yes.
Pickens?
Yes.
Delaney?
Yes.
All right. Motion carries. Any citizens here wishing to address the board for our senior fund? All right, moving on. On the new business, I do have our report, bus report this month. With 18 days that were worked, we had the number of trips was 541 trips. Average per day was 30 and a half. We had one event that occurred on Wednesday the 27th. Afternoon, bus one had the lift quit working. The driver had two wheelchairs out, and the driver needed to use the manual hand pump to get the lifts operating. Thursday morning, we rented a van to keep the schedule on track, and we sent the bus in to get fixed. It says we'll be using the van until the bus is ready, but the bus is back. We rented the van for 4 days.
And the bill for the rental will be with that next month?
Yeah, that'll be
late?
Next month.
Okay.
Bill just, yeah.
Okay.
I have no other business.
Ron, I just have a quick question. The number of trips made at 541, is that back and forth?
How do you say it?
Per day is back and forth, too?
Yes.
Thank you.
I have no other business.
I have one question. Did you make any progress in purchasing the vehicle for?
Well, yeah. I had one to show you today, but I stole it right before I came down. It's sold.
Okay.
So we were kind of waiting on the one from the city, Lockport, that they told us was going to be back this next month. So that seems to be the best, and it's low miles, and it wasn't used much by Joliet, by the city of Lockport, but the fact is, it won't be available until next month. So we are starting to look again to see if we can come across something that we can find. That this is a kind of a nice one. It's a 2018 Dodge Caravan. so.
What was the cost on that?
That was 19.2.
Okay.
19.3, 219, 299. But, so. I wish I did have something. But I have nothing else unless there's any other questions or comments. I entertain a motion to adjourn.
I'll make that motion.
I got a motion by Barb Boyce.
Second.
By Greg Pickens. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have. All right. Now we're in the town fund. Again, you have the minutes of the monthly meeting of February 5th, which includes the February 26th recess meeting. And you also have a bid opening meeting on January 31st, 2019. I do would entertain a motion to pass the minutes.
I'll make that motion to pass the minutes.
I got a motion by Bob Boyce.
Second.
Second by Greg Pickens. Any questions or minutes? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have. We have the bills of $52,294.67. Do we need a motion to pay the bills?
I'll make the motion to pay the bills.
I got a motion by Barb Boyce.
Second.
Second by Barb Delaney. Any questions of the bills? Hearing none, can I have a roll call, please?
Delaney?
Yes.
Pickens?
Yes.
Alberico?
Yes.
Boyce?
Yes.
Morelli?
Yes.
All right, thank you. Passes. Any citizens wishing to address the board for the town front? Please sign up, state your name for the record.
If I may, Mark?
Yes, please. We're going to have our attorney really quick read this. There's a copy of our resolution as to the time of speaking and
this is just a sort of minor. It was a resolution of the past in 2016. It's resolution number 2016-1 concerning public comment. Following guidelines are established for this portion of the public meeting. Comments shall be received only after the commenting party or after speaker is recognized by the moderator conducting the meeting. Each speaker before addressing the board shall be required to sign an attendance roll upon which is stated his or her name, address and subject upon which the speaker proposes to address the board. The speaker shall proceed to the microphone or podium at the front of the meeting room and announce his or her name prior to addressing the board. The moderator may roll out of order, scandalous, impertinent, irrelevant, and redundant comments or comments, the discernible purpose of which is to disrupt or needlessly detract the proceedings of the meeting. The moderator may request that any individual to leave the meeting and may contact security to that end. When the individual does not observe reasonable decorum. Further, the moderator may request the assistance of law enforcement officers to remove a disorderly person when his or her conduct interferes with the orderly progress of the meeting. The moderator may call a recess or adjournment to another time when the lack of public decorum interferes with the orderly conduct of the meeting. The moderator may allocate available time among individuals wishing to comment. Time allocated for the public comment period at each meeting shall not exceed 30 minutes. Each speaker shall be allotted 3 minutes to present his or her topic. Said time limitation shall be altered or waived at the moderator's discretion. At the discretion of the moderator conducting the meeting, a group of citizens registered to address the board on the same issue may be required to designate a spokesman or spokeswoman. At the discretion of the moderator conducting the meeting, residents and or taxpayers of the township may comment on issues being discussed during the meeting other than during public comment. Residents and or taxpayers may use audio or stenographic recorders to record all or any portion of the meeting. Said recorders shall be operated when the area is decided for the general public seating may not be placed on the board of trustees table without prior consent of the moderator. remind everyone that there are rules in place for public comment.
All right, thank you. Please state your name.
Good evening, my name is Gabrielle Comstock. I'm an attorney with Keough and Moody, and we represent the Lakewood Falls Community Association. Having just heard that resolution, I certainly will keep my comments to a minimum because I do know we also would like to share our time with our board president from the association, who can give you a better understanding of the association's the financial impact that they proposed, the ordinance and the contract with Homewood Disposal has on the Lakewood Falls Association. You have before you a folder that the association's board president put together for you, and included in there is a letter which we have prepared for each of you trustees outlining the basis for the association's position. Mr. Livingstone, the board president, also included some other helpful documents for when he addresses the trustees as well. Just briefly, we all know that there was a referendum. We all know that it passed. And the reason for the objection by Lakewood Falls Association is that the gist of it is that the representations that were made to the voters prior to the vote being passed were very clear in trying to educate the owners. And those representations made it clear there would be an opt-out. And those representations made it clear that the purpose of providing this referendum and for exploring these options was to assist those associations in the unincorporated area that those homes didn't have scavenger services. Lakewood Falls has scavenger services. Lakewood Falls owners showed up to vote. I'm not sure whose poster board that is over there, but it even shows that Lakewood Falls owners voted in favor because the representations made to them were that there would be the ability to opt out for those, specifically it's stated in the representations, associations that have a service available to them. And it specifically made it clear that there would be, you can expect, lower prices. Mr. Livingstone will address in a moment why those factors are not inapplicable to the association, because the prices won't be lower for them. And more importantly, they were given the option to vote, and they did vote, but they voted based on the representation that they would have the ability to opt out. And now the proposed contract with Homewood Disposal does not allow Lakewood Falls to opt out. That representation is the reason you have such a high percentage of owners voting in favor. And that's the reason why today we come before you hoping to restore the trust, because we understand a referendum passed and you have to do something with that referendum. But the plain language of that referendum is to ensure that the unincorporated areas would have the ability to have a scavenger service. It doesn't state all of the unincorporated areas. And again, even looking at the RFP, looking at the representations prior to the referendum, the intent was for those who did not have the service. And in fact, when you look at the history behind it all, and there was a community that needed that assistance, and that should be provided. But to now interfere with the association who has a contract, and more importantly, has a declaration that requires their association to provide scavenger service, and to provide this service to their members, to now require them to basically be in a situation where they can't comply with their governing documents, which is a violation of the law, is putting them in an adverse position. But most importantly, it's based on the representations that were made and why you got a turnout and why you were part able to see such a high percentage of the Lakewood Falls community voting in favor. They believe those representations. And now after the referendum is passed, the terms changed. My letter states in greater detail, which is included in Exhibit A, more of the information as to the association's position. But again, in the interest of time and in respect of your time as well, I would ask that the trustees now hear from Mr. Livingstone so he can explain the financial impact of the statement that I made that it is not going to lower the prices for the association, an association that has private streets, streets that they have to maintain, streets that comes out of the pocket of their owners. This Homewood Disposal contract doesn't provide them any protection as it relates to those streets. They have, under that contract, will have waived all claims if Homewood's allowed to come onto their property. They will not have the proper insurance indemnifying them that they have now under a contract with their provider. And it also, it indemnifies and holds harmless Homewood Disposal for any damage they cause to their property. That's not the
first thing I'd like to do is, I'd like you to turn to Exhibit B. And I'd like to, I'm trying to have the board understand that Lakewood Falls has rules and regulations as it relates to our property. So in the Exhibit B, you'll notice that there's items that talk about the height of grass. We have rules that require that the grass needs to be cut and cannot be longer than 8 inches. Trees properly trimmed along the parkway, and all weeds are removed. The reason for me pointing this out is that the board has negotiated a contract with Waste Management that includes all refuse, okay, so that our homeowners can take care of their lawns. They can cut the grass, they can take care of the trees, trim it, as per the rules and regulations that they are bound by in part of our community. So if you look at Exhibit C, you'll notice that the Waste Management contract with Lakewood Falls, there's an excerpt from that, that states that this yard waste is included with their monthly fee. There's no additional charge for it. It's part of the negotiated fee that we have with our contractor. I'd like to point to Exhibit D. Exhibit B is the Lockport Township contract, an excerpt from it, that states that yard waste is not included with the standard service. There is an additional fee for that. So what I'm trying to show to the board is that our residents will need to have that service in order for them to comply with the rules and regulations of our bylaw and to keep the community looking good. So I'd like to now turn to Exhibit E. Exhibit E is a cost comparison breakdown between the two contracts. As of you know, your Lockport Township, the contract that you're looking at adopting today has a couple different prices. There's a price that includes, that does not have any waste for removal for grass clippings and whatnot, and then there's an additional fee on top of that. So if we compare that as a like-to-like service for the contract that Lakewood Falls has, you'll see that our residents, our 869 residents, will pay more than $1 million extra over the course of your 7-year contract to have like-for-like service. That's money that you're taking out of our residents' pockets and putting it into a private company for something that we already have for much cheaper. The next point I'd like to make is Lakewood Falls owns and operates over 18 miles of streets. These are private roads. That's our largest expenditure that we have from the Board of Directors. This year we're going to spend about $900,000 fixing our roads and maintaining our roads. And we spent $7.5 million over the last 10 years. In Exhibit F, you'll notice that the Lockport contract, as alluded to earlier, states that neither the Lockport Township nor the contractor is held responsible for any damages. Zero. They could run over a mailbox in one of our residents' mailbox or hit a light pole. We maintain light poles, all 400 or 500 of them, right? Per the contract that you have in front of you that you're looking at ratifying tonight, they're not held responsible for any of those damages. Now, if you also look at an excerpt from the Lakewood Falls contract that we have with Waste Management, you'll notice that we have language in our contract that helps protect our assets and our community's assets. We hold the contractor responsible for those issues. That's a contract that we have negotiated because this is our property. So I hope the board understands that we have to protect the assets of our community. One of the largest assets. So I'm here tonight I understand that you have to do something, right? There was a referendum, and I agree, you have to do something. I'm on the board as well. And I'm asking you to stick to your own RFP definition and maps, Exhibit G, that shows what areas of your, what was included in the scope of this when you first put it up for bid. I'm asking you stick to the wording and the communication that you set to your own residents of Lockport Township, in your own newsletter, Exhibit H, stating a homeowners association will automatically be opted out. That is what you had sent to all of your residents prior to the referendum going up to vote for the residents. I hope you agree with me that many inconsistencies and some of the changing scope contract, is problematic, right? I mean, we know that you have to do something, but there's a lot of things that have been going on here that, that may need to be looked at. I hope you understand that if you continue with this contract as worded without any options excluding Lakewood Falls, moreover, literally calling out Lakewood Falls as being included. That was a change from the contract from the last period when I was here. Saying that we are absolutely included is going to cost our homeowners an additional $1 billion over the life of that span of that contract. And if the board decides to adopt the Lockport Township contract, I hope you understand that we have no other option than to protect our residents per our own bylaws and per what we have to do. That's a state law requires the board of directors to approve the subdivision. Thank you.
Thank you for your comments. Appreciate it. Any other citizens wishing to address the board here tonight? If everybody's going to speak on the same thing, at all, I would like to get it down to one or two people. Rather than have everybody here will be here all night. I would like to hear as much as I can. All right?
Thank you. My name is Jessica Kennedy. I am 21514 Franklin Circle. I am a resident of Lakewood Falls, and I am a Lockport Township registered voter. I first want to thank the trustees for tabling the contract last month to allow for more time and more consideration. As an unincorporated Lockport Township resident and registered voter, I'm here before you today to once again address our community's concerns with the proposed waste disposal contract. Not only is this a contract that our community is not happy with, it's one we should have never been included in the first place. And I want to address the communications and where we have got to this point through the referendum process. I want to start with the meeting of March 15th, 2018. At this meeting, there was a question submitted for approval for the annual town meeting agenda, and it read as follows. Shall the Lockport Township Board of Trustees be authorized to contract or license a refuse collection, disposal, and recycling program on behalf of all residents of unincorporated Lockport Township, pursuant to Section 85-13 F and Article 210 of the Township Code? At this point, Trustee Delaney asked, and I quote, who posed the question this way? Chair Crumshaw had replied that two residents submitted the petition and came in with the same question. At this point, I'd like to pause here because, number one, I found it incredibly odd that two individuals from two separate communities would circulate identical petitions. Secondly, Lakewood Falls has circulated a similar petition that is up for consideration at this meeting. And I understand by letter I received yesterday from the township attorney that our petition is to be denied. It should be understood that our petition is not seeking clarification of the referendum question. It's moving to limit the reach of this contract as it relates to garbage, which is under the power of the electorate. It also falls under powers 29 to 31. This is the language that the residents asked for before the township law launched a confusing process for all the residents at the last town meeting. Mind you, the denial of our petition states that last year's agenda item was vigorously discussed and after a vote of the electors approved as it was presented. So I would like to review the annual meeting from 2018. At the meeting on April 4th, the measure passed with only one comment prior to it passing. It looked like the meeting was going to close in record time. However, once the floor was open to other business, things went haywire. And this is where the vigorous discussion ensued. One resident asked, and I quote, the question be modified to exclude the body of rating of your communities. Another resident stated that the question seems to set up an automatic conflict for residents that they already have favorable rates that they negotiated. I wouldn't want to interfere with their right to negotiate that rate. End quote. Then Mr. Daskin of the City of Lockport took the podium and stated, and I quote, unfortunately what has happened here tonight is a can of worms has been opened. What has now happened is a population of people is greater than the potential of other unincorporated areas and have absolutely no reason to vote yes for this. This is going to fail as written. What you had here is a great idea, but absolutely terrible language.
I'm sorry. I'll let you continue.
Thank you. I appreciate that very much. When the electorate continued to argue to modify the language so that communities participating in other programs and contracts to be excluded to give the measure a better chance to pass, Attorney Mueller stated there is nothing available to amend this. It will come down to educating all the voters as to why it's important. It's for everybody, and it's going to come down to education. The electors of the town meeting wanted to rescind the vote and amend the resolution to reflect something that had a better chance of passing. When asked where the law said that the electorate could not amend their vote, Mr. Mueller responded, and I quote, "I'm not going to give you the chapters and the numbers." At this point, a Fairmont resident came to the podium and stated, "When we started this discussion under the guidance of the township supervisor, it kept being suggested that this is the route we have to go. Hearing other individuals tonight, I'm kind of confused because it seems we've been spoon-fed crap. This is a slap in our face and we've been set up to fail," end quote. At this point, the president of the Fairmont Community Partnership stated the following, I quote, "I want to say that the question that was presented was hand-delivered to me by Ron Alberico. One of his attorneys prepared that question. The verbiage was supposed to exclude the communities. The question was prepared for us to fail," end quote. At this point, Mr. Mueller interjected and told the electorate that while there may be no ability to change the actual referendum language, the board can craft a contract so it doesn't include specific communities. He stated, and I quote, "We don't have an option to change the verbiage, but the township board can contract with whatever rates provider and decide what services they will provide and when. It's up to your township board to come up with the best contract." He then stated, "My opinion is that to make sure people in gated communities understand, it only affects you if you want to." And just 13 days later, that's exactly what Supervisor Alberico began to do. On April 17th, he's quoted in the Daily Southtown stating, and I quote, "We will negotiate for all unincorporated areas that do not have a system in place," end quote. As we got closer to the election, the message became even more clear. On October 1st, there was a quote in the Lockport legend from Supervisor Alberico saying, "There are several unincorporated areas of Lockport Township that have waste collection contracts with the city or their individual homeowners associations. So anyone who isn't interested in being part of the township contract, should the referendum pass, would be able to opt out." Just prior to the election, Mr. Alberico stated in the fall of 2018 Lockport Township News Letter, "The program will include an opt-out clause, so if you are happy with your current provider and service, you can continue to use them. Also, households who are already have an organized solid waste and recycling agreement with the City of Lockport or a homeowners association will automatically be opted out." This was not an accidental language. This was not a mistake. This was a strategic way to communicate and to get the referendum to pass. The supervisor, Mr. Mueller, knew what it would take to pass a referendum, and this is the information we serve to residents. I'm here before you tonight to let you know that my community is also a hardworking middle-class community, and we care about our neighbors. This is why, with the information provided by the township, we voted to support providing affordable services to communities that need it. I urge you to please take a hard look at this entire process. It's important to remember that when the township supervisor or the township attorney speak, they speak for the entire board. Residents were skeptical about this referendum from the get-go, and promises were clearly made. Now that the referendum is passed, it's up to you, the trustees, to ensure whatever contract is approved keeps those promises that were made. It upholds the integrity of our township and proves to us that we can trust our employees. Thank you.
Thank you for your time. Any other citizens wishing to address the board here tonight? It will be about 10 more minutes, is all.
My name is Amy Weiss. I'm a resident of Lakewood Falls Association for probably the past 23 years. I voted after reading the description twice and reading the clause in that ballot that said homeowners associations would be opted out. I voted yes. To go ahead and say now that, oh no, that's not what we meant. That's wrong. I voted on what was on that ballot. I'm just saying that if you want to change what you are voting on, you should re-vote the referendum as written as you want it. Now, thank you.
employees at no additional cost. It required the service providers to pay the employees prevailing wages. It had liquidated damages for 120%. None of those things are in this new contract. And that was after just a quick cursory analysis. I'm sure there are a lot more. The township told the public twice in a few months what it was going to do. School these associations. It went behind closed doors. It classified bait and switch. And it had a whole new program that never went out to bid. The specs have been changed so much that this needs to go back out to bid for pursuant to statute. And if you vote in support of this, it's a vote in violation. It's a vote to violate the Illinois statute. It exposes the township to liability for multiple associations and service providers. And so we ask that you reject the ordinance. Thank you.
And then they came to the table.
on Lakewood Falls at Section 6 in Lockport Township. Based upon all the evidence that's been given here tonight, I urge you as members of the board to please relook at the actions that you're about to take on here. See, a lot of points have been made here, and you really need to take a second look. I urge you to do that. Thank you.
Yes, my name is Jerry Weiss. I am a 23-year resident at Lakewood Falls. I'm here this evening, as we all know, because of the contracts that are being put out. Our subdivision, Lakewood Falls Homeowners Association, they have a rock solid contracts. They've had over many decades that I've lived there, including our garbage contract. Very quickly, I can tell you, and I can only go back 10 years in my financial records. 10 years ago, I have a bank statement here, waste management. I've written them a check dated January 1st of 2009 for $51 for a quarter's worth of garbage pickup and grass clippings with that. That equates to $17 a month. Fast forward 10 years, December 26th of 2018, I just wrote waste management another check for garbage pickup along with grass clippings. The total amount of that check for this quarter was $62.79 for the quarter, which equals $20.93 per month. So within those 10 years of contracts with waste management, our monthly increase was only $3.93 a month over a 10-year period. So that just shows that the dedication that our board goes to work for our residents. And I would ask tonight that, being that Lockport News Letter that I got in my mailbox, I wholeheartedly, as a good neighbor, if I can help people across the town, why not vote for that and let them have what we have as far as price and services. Now that we see the whole contract being reviewed, it's not apples to apples. If you're comparing apples to watermelons, because now you're being charged for grass clippings, you're being charged for the garbage pickup separately according to these new contracts, which greatly increases our cost per month. And as a homeowner, I definitely am not happy about that. Your very own newsletter for the fall winter issue said we could opt out. I supported that with the opt-out in order to help the neighbors down the street and across the town. And that's not the way it's working out. With that being said, you know, the township, your very own mission statement is transparency. It speaks of transparency in that mission statement. And I feel there's been no transparency with this garbage collection. That's all I have for you. Thank you.
I'm sorry I didn't sign up to be in to talk, but I live on High Road and I had waste management for a number of years. When I moved back with my mother, I took over the garbage. She used to just burn her own backyard.
Can I stop you for a minute? Just say your name for
the record. Oh, sorry. Candy Gerja, High Road, Lockport Township. When I started doing it, it was like $50 a quarter. Fortunately, my next door neighbor worked for a recycling plant. And I dropped it last year, and it was $180 a quarter. They were kicking up the price every quarter by a couple bucks, and they did that the entire time I lived there. And when I finally called them and told them I was dropping it because I had this nice new neighbor who would take it to his recycling plant, they said, well, can we talk to you about the price? So they're not just doing it to me with my brain here. They're doing it to every other citizen in that unincorporated township with the gray hair. And if anybody wants to see the last bill that I had, that was last year, for $180 a quarter, or $720 a year, I'll be happy to show it. So we do need some kind of, what do I want to say, negotiation, get these people to do it the way they want to do it. So when you were talking about it, I was thinking, yeah, thank you.
I just want to make a comment. I live on High Road also. Mine's 202 a quarter.
was stated to the community what they truly voted on and what they need to do. But one item I want to talk about is regarding pricing. What you have in your packet is an extension of our contract. We're happy to give you a copy of it again. So, just like any other contract, we have the ability to amend. Just like you have the ability to amend, right? That's a real deal. A signed, sealed, delivered. Those are real prices. So as you can see, your prices for like services are over 60% higher than what our residents are paying today. So those are real numbers. I just want to make sure there's no, you know, magic projections or anything like that. That is a contract. So that's been signed. Thank you.
Thank you. Anybody else? All right, I'm going to close the public comment time. Unless this point will just close it, we'll add to our assessment report. All right. I've saved a couple minutes.
Okay, let's try it.
We'll move on to our clerk's report.
Well, unfortunately, I'm not going to save any time on things, so we do have to approve the annual town meeting agenda tonight, the Board of Trustees. So in your packets is the annual town meeting. As Jessica said earlier, she did put a request in for the annual town meeting to be on the agenda. And after giving it to our attorney, Gary Mueller, I don't know if Gary wants to comment on that.
Good evening. I was asked to provide a legal opinion concerning the propriety of the proposed question to be added to the agenda for the annual town meeting. For the following reasons, I think the request should be denied. The way that the request reads in the petition is as follows. We, the undersigned registered voters of Lockport Township, do hereby petition the clerk of Lockport Township to add to the agenda of the annual township meeting for the consideration of the electors the proposition as to whether the Lockport Township Board of Trustees authorization to contract, administer, or license a refuse, garbage, and recycling collection and disposal program shall be limited only to those portions of unincorporated Lockport Township which are not part of a duly organized common interest community association as defined by applicable statute that's already contractually obligated to provide some services to its members. By way of background, the electors in 2018 at their annual meeting sought the township board to approve in the agenda for the meeting the following issue, which actually is how it read in the ballots. So the representations tonight about what was on the in the ballot having something other than what I'm about to read are unfortunately misplaced and inaccurate. So what was actually on the ballot was the following. Shall the Lockport Township Board of Trustees be authorized to contract, administer or license a refuse collection, disposal, and recycling program on behalf of all residents of unincorporated Lockport Township pursuant to section 85-13F and Article 210 of the Township Code. After the discussion was held at the end of the town meeting, the proposal I just read was approved. Township Board thereafter submitted the request from the annual meeting to the county clerk for placement of the referendum on the ballot to be considered, and it was so placed on the ballot, the referendum was overwhelmingly approved. Petition submitted appears to seek clarification of a referendum question that was already discussed prior to passage of the last annual town meeting and was already approved by the registered voters of the unincorporated Lockport Township. Pursuant to section 60 ILCS 1/30-5, the Township Board sets the agenda for the annual town meeting. Pursuant to 60 ILCS 1/30-25, except as well as 60 ILCS 1/235-5, 1/235-10, and 605 ILCS 5/6-506. The electors have specific powers that may be exercised at an annual meeting. The electors only retain those specific powers the legislature has extended to them. The clarification requested in the petition is not included within any of the specific powers enumerated by the legislature. Thus, the petition must be denied as outside the specific enumerated powers of the electors at annual town meeting. That is my legal opinion, but it obviously is up to the township board whether to allow this request to move forward and be placed on the agenda for the annual town meeting.
Supervisor, with all due respect, that was not the accurate language from the ballot, because the ballot does not say all of the
So by further clarification, then the representations that talked about there being opt-out language within the ballot is absolutely incorrect. There was no opt-out language within the ballot.
It was in the description.
I understand, but it was at all the unincorporated areas, and that's not the ballot. I wasn't disputing that. That's what Mr. Mueller had indicated. It was the language in the ballot when he referred it to saying all of the unincorporated areas, and it's not what the ballot said. But on behalf of the residents of the unincorporated areas of the township.
That clause was in the description.
Please
explain.
You have the time to talk, but we're trying to carry on the meeting here. Thank you. So that being said, the agenda for...
The agenda that is in front of you does not include the petition request. We can add it if the board would like, but it does not have it. We can put it in.
So now we want to make a motion to accept this as the annual town meeting agenda. Is that what you're asking?
One that was provided.
Right here.
And if you want to add this or not, please.
Well, just for clarification, so it is up to us trustees this evening, or the majority of us up here, if we would like to see this petition placed on the annual town meeting, we are able to do so.
Well, the correct answer is that it's not within the statute that allows for that to be included. So you would have a right to do that, but please know that there's no legal basis for you to do that, in my opinion.
Okay. But I guess when you have a group of people who come before you, they have one time a year where they can get on an agenda for a town hall meeting and get something to vote. And we are basically going to deny them that one right of theirs to do that at the time if we do this. If we do not accept the annual, if we do accept the annual town meeting agenda as it is presented to us without amending it.
As I understand it, however, the legislation, however, also says that there's an end time when you have to at least get your submittal in by a certain time in order for it to be considered, but there's not a prior date. So if they brought this in December to see if that would fly, they could have done that. And they could have made a request and the board could have made a decision then. They did not. A number of years ago, we had a similar situation where residents came forward, made a request, and a petition to be included as an agenda item for the annual town meeting. This board was similarly constituted and said, it's not within those statutory references I mentioned here, and that question was not placed on the agenda. So there, I mean, the legislation is pretty clear. Those, I think it's roughly 38 things that you can, 38 things that you can actually discuss, and that the electors have the power and authority to ask the township board to consider. I mean, I'm not hearing the petitioner, I'm not hearing anyone on our behalf saying that this falls within any of those. And I really genuinely don't believe that it does.
Okay.
I believe you can discuss anything at the town meeting. Can we vote on anything? You can only vote on what is within the power of the electors. And that's not within the power of the electors, is what you're saying. The way I understand it, right? They don't have that power to ask that question at the town meeting to be voted on. You can discuss it at the town meeting. Discuss anything, I believe.
Sure.
So with that being said, how
would I guess, like I said, at this point, I would not have a problem. I know we need a consensus up here. I would not have a problem of adding this, their petition request, to the annual town hall meeting.
We wouldn't be able to vote on that if the town meeting is what we're saying.
But if it is amended and it is added to the annual town meeting, they can vote on it.
Now, if it's a question they can't ask. That's what you're saying. In the statutes, you can't ask that question that they're asking.
Okay.
There's only 38 things that they can ask. Okay. I mean, that is not one of them that's included. So we could discuss it. It's not something you have to vote on. You can't come to an annual town meeting and request that Lockport Township residents shouldn't wear seatbelts. That's not one of the questions that there's only certain things that can be asked, and that we're by law able to vote on. Am I saying that correctly?
I believe so.
Okay. Any other discussion?
Obviously, this is something new to us, I believe, in the board members. This is something that wanted to be put on the agenda, basically to be discussed or voted on.
They wanted us to put it on the agenda to be voted on.
By the people at the town meeting or by a referendum?
No, at the annual town meeting.
I would ask our attorney then, yes, again, if that's something that is, I don't know if you've done that before, that can vote at the meeting.
Well, no, we vote at, the electors do make decisions at the annual town meeting. For example, this building that we're in, there was, at the annual town meeting, there was a request at that time for the electors to approve pursuing the purchase of the building. That particular request was presented at the annual town meeting, there was discussion and it passed. That was how we proceeded to end up being here. On the actual question about the garbage agreement, that was presented at the last annual town meeting, it was discussed, and it was approved to go ahead and authorize the board to proceed to get it on a ballot, and have the voters decide, and then the voters overwhelmingly decide. This, the other reason, in addition to saying that I don't believe it's covered by any of the 38 items that you actually can use in order to get on the annual town meeting agenda, honestly, I don't know what this says. Meaning, it appears to say, even though the referendum's already passed, we want you, board, to reconsider what's already passed. That's how I read this. What they may have meant might be different than that, but the way I read this was reconsider what referendum was.
Jessica, would you like to come and explain to the board the petition? Is that okay, so everybody understands?
We already did have.
Well, but this is concerning the agenda item, so.
Thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to address this issue again. The petition before you has been submitted under the power of the electorate that, in our understanding, can deal with the garbage and the trash removal, much like the agenda item that was presented that came to our referendum. The reason that we submitted this is, I'm very clear here, I don't want to be missing. Essentially, we want to clarify, we want to make sure that we are opted out, whether there's the availability to opt out as we stated in the referendum This is something that we'd like to bring to the town meeting to make sure that the opt-out option, which is the communication that we're provided throughout the referendum process, is there. So again, the petition is not seeking clarification of the referendum question. It's moving to limit the reach of this contract as it relates to garbage, which is under the power of the electorate, and also falls under Power 29. This language is the language, again, that the residents asked for at the last town meeting.
I believe that was an advisory question for referendum. That's how, and that is something that the electors can do at any other town meeting. If I'm correct,
the initial question, yes. Sir, last year.
Was an advisory.
This is now, and I guess I can't stress enough, it says, the last four lines, they want the question to be limited only to those portions of unincorporated Lockport Township which are not part of the duly organized common interest community association as defined by the applicable statute that is already contractually obligated to provide such services to its members. That then is a clarification slash revision slash, I don't care what verb you use, but it is to change the referendum question that was already passed. Now what this young lady has mentioned tonight is she's doing exactly what she wants to be able to do at the annual town meeting, which is to be able to present her argument to say, board, since you're now empowered to come up with a contract with some waste service, board, please consider opting us out. based upon all the reasons that they gave, based upon the binder that was given by the president. That's exactly what they're asking to do, and they've done so tonight. And that, I think, is actually the appropriate place to do it, is at a regular meeting tonight. That is not something for the annual town meetings. Because the annual town meeting isn't equipped to, in essence, say, please further define what's going to be in that contract. Because if you think about it, and we take it to its logical conclusion then, this would suggest, if we allow this, the electors could come forward and say, we didn't like the contract that you had, or the lease that you had with Meals on Wheels. So we want you to renegotiate that. No, that's not an annual town meeting discussion. That's a discussion when the board is presented with a lease by Meals on Wheels. And someone says, hey, wait a minute, you gotta make sure you have insurance on there. Or, wait a minute, we need to have somebody monitoring who's using our building so that we know who's coming and going. Which, by the way, are all questions that have been presented to our board, that have been presented at meetings. So I guess at the end of the day, I agree with her in that she wants to get that question discussed. That's what we're doing tonight. That's what the board can do tonight. That's what the board can do at any meeting. The annual town meeting, however, is very, very specific. And that's really what I'm hanging my legal opinion on, is that it's very specific. It only can handle those 38 items that are listed by statute. This is not one of those. And that's why I would suggest that the board should deny the request. Doesn't mean please stop listening to her, or please don't take into account her concerns, or the concerns of the association, or the concerns of those who may be adversely affected by a proposed agreement. Absolutely listen to them. Absolutely, this is what the discussion points are for. But not the other one.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, Jess.
All right, that being said, entertain a motion to approve the annual town meeting agenda.
As presented.
As presented. Well, we have to pass the agenda. I will make the motion. Do you want to second it?
I'll second it.
You'll second it? All right. I made the motion. Greg Pickett seconded it. Let's go.
Alberico?
Yes.
Delaney?
No.
Pickus?
Yes.
Boyce?
Yes.
Morelli?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Motion carries.
Thank you. Well, we do have something fun coming up. Lockport Township Community Fun Day. And I would love for all of the Lakewood Falls to come and bring their families and the Fairmont community leaders tonight and whoever else is here, because I think it's going to be an
with the new ones that they put in the front, they came out and replaced some stuff with that one. That should be under their warranty. I did have a conversation, actually it was just today, with a young lady, Heather. Person Grove, about a community garden. I know we've approved back years, a couple of years ago, about putting a community garden on the side of the building. Last year it didn't happen because the person that was volunteered to help put it together got busy and he got a new job promotion and he couldn't do it, so it kind of fell apart last year. This young lady stepped up and said she would like to at least try to put it together, so I'm excited about that. We can do a little soil samples first to see if the soil is good in that area. If everything goes good, I would like to be able to start putting them, we're going to start small, baby steps, with a community garden in the side of the north end of the building. Hopefully it'll be opened up to our residents who don't have a yard they would want to plant. They can come plant a little spot here. And I'd also like to include an area that would go to the food pantry. So all the food that's grown in one area could go over to the food pantry. I know you might be asking Fairmont's, some of the people from Fairmont, I know they have a food community garden. They've done pretty good. I'd like to ask their help on that too, and some advice in putting that together. But hopefully that'll come along pretty good. The other thing I did want to bring up, and I did have a meeting on March 4th, I think I have a thing with your thing, basically saying the same thing, with one of our staff, Michelle, and I met with Dave Herman from the Park District and Nikki, or Nikki from the Park District, along with Sue and Tammy from the Meals on Wheels program. We had a discussion about kind of merging the two programs together. The thought was to have both programs run on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. The Park District would like to bring their bingo game here that they do at Glen Stocks, bring it into this building since the parking is better. It'd be 9 to 11 on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Coffee would be served here at this time. Luncheons would be served through the Meals on Wheels for those wishing to attend. A $4 donation is suggested for the Meals on Wheels program. After lunch, there would be card games, board games, and that kind of stuff. Mentioned the Mexican training game, which I don't know what that is. Southern Gin Rummy, Canasta, Yahtzee. And more refreshments will be provided for those game-playing games. Cornhole will be available once a month.
I just have a question.
Sure.
What is that?
It's cornhole? I don't know what that is.
You know, you have bags.
Is it
bags.
Kind of like a bags game?
Yeah. Okay.
It's from the South.
Okay. You know it. We hope to start this in the fall. Meals on Wheels is available for all residents who qualify who are 60 and over. AARP will be joined on this program on every other Wednesday. They go from 10 to 11. They'll be doing a class here for the residents, for our seniors, in the morning, and then they have lunch. Lunch will be served. The meals will be provided by the Meals on Wheels. After lunch, the Park District will work with the games again on these Wednesdays. So it sounds like this whole building was to put a community center together for our residents. It sounds like it's going to get some kids in here. So I'm pretty excited about getting some of this stuff going with this building.
Can I have a favor? Can we, as officials, can we have an input on some of the things? Because sometimes they're so
loud.
It's very loud in my offices, and even with the door shut.
I'm hoping that the bingo game is long enough to go in the side building.
And I do have a request that this does not happen during early voting. It's just very disruptive to have noise and things, especially my office being downstairs. Well, even I guess upstairs, the noise. If you could just contain it to a room,
we have luncheons here every day.
No, those are quite
well,
beautiful.
They are seniors.
Wow. On election day.
They are. They play
people. On April 2nd, the stealth served with two precincts here. Right. So it's here. Yeah, so April 2nd.
Day.
Okay.
Election
okay.
Day.
Just to make sure.
And it's not going to happen until the fall anyway.
Yeah, but next year's 2020. That's a presidential election. So it gets
Springfield. It's going to be April 3rd. It's a very educational day. Get to talk to all your state senators and representatives. I think it's very educational. I do know I have a couple of people on our board that has requested to go, so I'll put it up to 9, and then we'll just send whoever requests to go. Entertain a motion to approve the registration.
I'll make a motion that we approve the good topics.
All right.
Second.
We got a motion by Greg Mikus and a second by Barb Delaney. Any comments? Hearing none, can I have a roll call, please?
Delaney?
Yes.
Mikus?
Yes.
Alberico?
Yes.
Boyce?
Yes.
Morelli?
Yes.
All right, next on the agenda is approval of ordinance number 2019-1, establishing a refuse collection and disposal. I have that. Resolution. That's not it. I'm scared all over the
I guess I would like to make a motion at this time that we reject ordinance number 2019-1 and have a new RFP created. What was initially advertised in many forms of print, starting with the newsletter that went out from the supervisor of Lockport Township, that when people can automatically opt out if they are in a homeowners association. So I would just like to make the motion to reject this ordinance and have a new RFP created and have our attorney, Mr. Gary Mueller, included in the entire RFP process from the beginning to the very end.
I second the motion.
Okay. First, as a board, we did put this referendum question in the hands of law firm. That's all right. It's a board decision to do that.
You want to amend your motion to include Rathburn?
Yes, I will amend it to
include Rathburn. I second it.
Do you understand this will delay the garbage pickup probably for it's already up to June. It'll probably be September before we get this off, except for the residents.
Well, last night we decided that the water department was going to give an extra month to the to evaluate the sale of the water department, and this is the same matter that we need to consider all the residents and make sure that I think that everybody came into this process of collection with good intentions. But when the time came to put pen to paper and come up with a contract, we failed. That's where we failed. The negotiations with the waste collection company failed and misrepresented the intent of the referendum, as most voting residents understood it to be available as an opt-out. So I think the intent of the referendum is not being presented by the contract we have in front of us.
Well, all right, that's the way you feel.
Why did it take that long, though? October, you're talking.
By the time we go through another RFP, it's going to be the same thing. We're going to come up to the same issues that we have here today. My suggestion is to pass the ordinance tonight. That'll get this thing rolling. Carl, do you have a comment on this? This ordinance doesn't answer the question.
Water board. So.
He's in the
board. Good evening. Carl Buck, working with the board and trying to prepare the ordinance with the county. The process following up on the referendum is to first pass some reason Lockport fails to provide them water and ceases to provide them with garbage service, by virtue of the referendum, they're still included within the referendum, and you, as the township, would be obligated to provide them with garbage service. So I propose that to you first as an explanation for the process and to clarify any statements that the referendum process or the referendum question were correct. With respect to the ordinance is the enabling act and it allows you then, as a board, go on and effectuate the referendum. Whether or not you choose to review the contract with homeowners or go to an RFP, that's separate and distinct from approving the ordinance. So I would suggest that you approve the ordinance, authorizing yourself as a board and as a township to then enter into a contract for refuse service. If you decide as a board that you want to submit the contract to a second RFP process because you believe that a second RFP process will be in the best interest of the township, you may do that as a board. You certainly have the right to do that. You also have the right under the township code to establish rules and regulations relative to the administration of the refuse system. So, for those reasons, I think you should approve the ordinance, or I would recommend that you approve the ordinance, because it effectuates your referendum, the referendum that was lawfully passed by the electors. If you then choose as a board to go to a second RFP process, you choose to do that, there's certainly nothing legally wrong with your RFP process. Your RFP process complies with the statute, and there's no issue with respect to that. If you want to do it again, because you as a board decide that that's in the best interest of the township, you certainly have the right to do that. In addition, you also have the right to pass on other rules and regulations under the township code relative to the administration of your refuse collection.
Can I clear that up a little bit? Can you understand that? Good. Ask the ordinance.
I think I understand what his point is as far as the ordinance. The ordinance justifies the referendum that was passed by the electorate. So if we pass this ordinance as is, does that mean we're accepting the contract?
No.
I don't see anything else. Okay, we do have old business approval of the garbage contract. So this was that motion that that Barb made could be made at the approval of the garbage contract to go to another RFP. Correct.
You have the right to do that. You also have the right under the township code to establish rules and regulations for the administration of the refuse collection. So under my Brian Gray example, you know, 5 or 10 years from now, I'm not saying the Lockport's going to lose their water service, but at some point the city of Lockport may decide not to service Brian Gray. You're going to have to then include them pursuant to the referendum. You're going to have to address them through your rules and regulations. So you're going to be administering this program in many different ways.
So then what the motion that I had entertained a few moments ago is more proper to put under the state that under the approval of the garbage contract opponent.
Correct.
Okay. Yeah, because the contract won't be. I mean, I understand we need to move forward because it did go to referendum, it did pass.
Correct.
Okay.
So this attached to the ordinance is appropriate as it be social control for the purpose of the refuse collection.
If it's not approved, then it doesn't become part of the ordinance. Because the ordinance authorizes the execution of the contract. The reason that the contract is on is because they actually have to approve the contract too, that's pursuant to the township system. So if there's no contract approved, then there's no service to be provided. So they're still going to have to go, they're still going to have to go through a process of approving the contract.
But if you have the ordinance and not the agreement, the ordinance still says that the contract shall control the purpose of the service administered on the refuse collection is full of years and drives. If they're bound by the agreement, whether it's moving the ordinance or the agreement.
No, they're not. They still have to have a valid contract that's approved as pursuant to the township.
It's attached to the exhibit the ordinance.
Well, I guess I have a question. So this is where I'm getting a little bit confused. Now, this question is, I guess, going to be directed to our attorney, Gary Mueller. Gary, were you involved in the RFP from the very beginning, through it, and to the end of the creation of this?
No.
Okay. I guess I'm kind of surprised to see Attorney Carol Buck here because I thought I was under the impression that Carol Buck is our representation for our water board. So we have two attorneys here this evening.
No,
Carl Buck was not, but Carl, let me ask you, Carl, then, were you involved at all in the RFP process, either in the beginning, the middle, or the end?
In the RFP, no.
Okay.
I was involved in the contract process and the ordinance process.
Then I'm not gonna rescind my motion to reject the ordinance, because I will not accept this ordinance.
So, I do have another question. I'm looking for Exhibit A in here that's listed under Section 2. Is Exhibit A shall be used to identify the service area for the unincorporated area of Lockport Township. In the agreement for services attached here to is Exhibit B. So if we do, assuming this agreement is with, I'm reading on the second page of the ordinance. The ordinance is what we're referring to right now. So just, I'm gonna be clear on this. Exhibit A is nothing's marked Exhibit A in my packet. Is there something that I'm missing?
I don't have your packet, but the way I read that, Greg, and I may be wrong, but Exhibit A shall be used to identify the service areas for the unincorporated area of Lockport Township. That exhibit hasn't been put together yet, because that's part of the argument here.
So we can't approve an ordinance that doesn't include all the information?
No. Unincorporated areas of the township for the purposes of the referendum is a map that's attached. So I don't know why it's in the packet, but the unincorporated areas of the
township. Well, in Section 3, it says the agreement for service is attached here to as Exhibit B. So the agreement for service, I assume, is the contract with Republic.
Yeah.
So that's included here. So I can't, I would not suggest to proceed with this ordinance as stated. Because it includes the agreement for service, so that we're bound to this agreement for service if we approve the ordinance.
Under the township code, because you still have to approve the agreement, it has to be separate. You can't approve an agreement inside an ordinance. So that's why it's separate. That's why it's timed and rejected twice. So you have to approve the ordinance, then you have to approve the agreement. For the purposes of scheduling the agenda, you could put the agreement first and then you would have the second. It wouldn't matter, you know, for scheduling. Because under the township code, you have to approve them separately. You can't approve them inside the other.
If we approve the ordinance, then what's the use? Then do we have to approve another ordinance if it's a different contract? Because we need a different
contract. No, then approve the contract. That's what I'm saying, is the ordinance enables the board to execute the contract. You still have to approve the contract under the township code.
If we decide to amend the contract, the exhibit from the ordinance will be different than what we approved.
It could be, but under the ordinance, you're entitled to do that, because you have the latitude pursuant to the township code of the records collection or section 210 to do that. That's why I use the example of Bonnie Gray. If at some future time you have to then include a provision of your unincorporated township that wasn't previously included, you could do that too.
Well, I guess my next question would be, who was involved in the creation of this ordinance?
I was.
Okay. But I guess that's where I'm getting confused, because Council Gary Mueller is the attorney for these meetings, whereas you are the representation for the water board. So now that you're being brought into...
Can I comment on that?
Sure.
I did talk to you personally. Mm-hmm. I talked to Greg personally. Mm-hmm. I did talk to Barb Boyce personally. Mm-hmm. I didn't talk to Dean, because Dean obviously was preoccupied with the death of his father.
Correct.
And all three of you guys told me that you would want me to put Carl Buck in charge of the referendum questions and take on the rest of the referendum.
But is that not something you're supposed to bring So you were involved with the ordinance?
Correct.
Okay. So, I mean, do you communicate with Gary Mueller with this? So, you know, he knows what's going on as well?
Correct.
Okay. And how often do you do that?
Well, we put this together last week, so other than providing him with a copy of it and meeting with him today, those are the two instances that we would have needed to do that.
So, do you want to not accept this? Is that still?
That is correct.
And are you still accepting that?
Yes.
Right, can I go for it?
Sure.
I mean, I would just ask Gary then, his opinion, reference number one, the ordinance, and then go from there. I mean, is there a discrepancy here?
Unfortunately, I did my hand for touch, because as directed by the supervisor, this was what Carl was going to do. So I wasn't involved in creating the ordinance. Had some discussion with the supervisor and representative from land use. It was about a 2.5 hour telephone conversation about the contract. But that was told that this is not my area, so I would leave that to confirm.
I know, obviously, there's a lot of information being presented to us. Like Trustee Vickas said, it started as a good intention thing to help out the residents of our which later on in the agenda about the approval of the agreement, etc. If the board chooses to table that, if the board chooses to decline that or whatever, the board then has that as a separate item, you can deal with that. This enables you to then utilize the power that was given to you in the referendum that passed. That says, yes, just reconfirming, you guys are the ones who are going to come up with some type of negotiated contract with a refuse disposal company. And when that happens, then that's what will be what controls for our company.
So,
okay, bye. So you could, yeah.
Can I ask you to obey for 30 seconds? In the copious treaty document, you know, it talks with the ordinance as exhibit A, it's going to identify the service area, mostly the map and isolation, but I think inadvertently a fly of Chamber of Commerce was attached as exhibit A instead. And I think it's another layer of document in the copious treaty, but the agreement is going to be, I think this was attached to the map, but.
The map available, and can I ask Mr. Mueller, the existing plan to have the rules and regulations, would that be part of the ordinance, or is that a separate issue?
Great question. I would suggest that we can address it through public comment. This would be a good time to address those kind of issues. To make sure that everybody's on the same page with those. The way that Carl drafted it, though, I support the way he did, and that it allows the board some flexibility to make sure that they can negotiate the best possible deal for everybody. And whatever the group that decides is going to be in there, after the discussion that we have today, after discussions probably they're pushing to a different date in the future, wherever we decided today, whichever. But
point being that we have to negotiate contract, the best contract that we can for everybody in the incorporated Lockport Township, not just Lakewood Falls. There's a lot of areas that are going to, their prices are going to go up a lot higher because of this argument. So I feel bad for the other residents. The other 2,000 as opposed to
the in opposite to your argument there, Ron, other companies came in and they assumed by the boundaries that were set that Lakewood Falls would be opted out as a homeowners association. And the rates that I'm looking at, this is the bid opening sheet right here, the rates for Republic were at 26, or no, Homewood was $25.95 and Republic was $26.36 and these are only Homewood and Republic's numbers here, but they were pretty similar. The prices weren't.
Waste Manager sent the next page.
The prices weren't that far off.
No, they weren't.
So I assume that if we put this out for RFP again and we gave them the exact parameters, they've already got all the information gathered. They could probably get back to us before the next meeting.
No, because I got to publish it in the paper. I've got to give them time to do the RFP. It's got to be published.
Let's publish it and say that they need to be back within a month.
That's what I did last time. So that'll put it off another. If I start tomorrow, it'll be about 2 months before we begin.
Why? Why can't we do this faster? I understand we got two. How long do we get a bid opening?
Look how long it took us to get from this point. This is a November election.
Well, I understand. The companies are going to be able to get back to us in a much more timely manner.
So you want to go back to bid?
Yes. Because I think the bids that we opened weren't, and I didn't study the bids as hard as I should have, but the bids that we opened weren't equal to each other. When we started negotiating this contract, we went into...
We all got the same RFP.
We went into areas that weren't covered under the RFP then.
And we also did not have our legal counsel, Gary Mueller, involved from the beginning, the middle, and the end of the creation of the RFP is what I'm requesting.
I don't know if that's always necessary. You know, the RFP was put together. The county walked me through it. They've been doing this
I just have a feeling if our attorney was involved in the beginning, the middle, and the end, I don't think we might have been here tonight.
Well, that's a matter of opinion, and I respect your opinion. I'm not going to go there tonight. But we got to move on. So if that's what you're, if you don't want to pass the ordinance, we'll start all over.
Jessica, can you repeat the motion that's on the table?
Motion is,
Or, sorry, I thought Jessica was right. I'm sorry.
That's okay. The motion by Barb Delaney is to reject ordinance number 2019-1 and include attorney Gary Mueller from the start to the finish and the RFP process to be redone.
As well as the involvement of the ordinance.
Well, you said you were going to resend that to the referendum. Did you want to resend that to have the referendum?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so is it Mueller and Rathburn, or is it just Mueller? Lockport is having their State of the City address. It's going to be on a Tuesday, April 16th, 11 to 2. I do need to know who all wants to go to that. Please email me so I have it. I appreciate you telling me tonight, but I know I'll forget. So please email me within the next day or two if you want to go to the City of Lockport. The other thing I wanted to bring up real quick, I got a letter from the United States Department of State, Chicago Passport Agency. Chicago Passport Agency Customer Service Department is writing in regards to your status as a passport application acceptance facility. After a thorough evaluation of the region, customer service officers deactivating the facility that no longer fills an essential need in the community. Lockport Township government accepted 28 applications in 17 and 13 in 2018. Surrounding application facilities in the area will be able to assist the population previously served by the facility. Lockport Township will be deactivated from passport applications acceptance facility effective April 15th. Started the business day of April 15th. Please remove and destroy all material. Basically, we weren't doing enough passports. We tried to help people out.
We had a few, you know, but didn't, like I said, 28, 13. So they took us off. So as of April 15th, we will not be able to passport them. We will still help any resident who comes in and get them through the passport, get it in the libraries, and I think the libraries are still free. I'm not sure if they got a letter too in most parts. Other than that, he's going to old business, which is the approval for the approval of the garbage contract of homeless disposal. I don't know if it's worth going through that at this point. If the ordinance didn't pass, I don't think there's a reason to take any action on that. I did want to mention here tonight about the scholarships. Everybody was supposed to bring their scholarship. So I know, Greg, you sent me yours. Anybody else that wants to give me their application as soon as possible, they don't make a decision.
When do you need the decision by? I apologize.
Tomorrow? Oh, sure. No, okay. You by the end of the week at least.
Okay.
You know,
okay.
We have some time, but
okay.
Yeah. Try to get to the guys that didn't get it by the end of the week. If you can do it, I'd appreciate it. Otherwise, we'll just tally up with the ones we got.
Okay.
Last month, I did hand out the emergency procedure manual to everybody for their reviews and comments. I don't know if anybody has any comments on that. I thought it was pretty
thorough. No, the review looks pretty good.
Thorough. Thanks. Maybe next month I'll put in for approval. This is our manual. You know, I think it'll be in the order in the minutes that we have. Last month, Will Grundy Medical Clinic was here. I said I was going to put it on the agenda. I apologize, I didn't get it on the agenda. I did have some conversations, though, with a couple of the townships, and they